From the Cannon River in Northfield to the Rapidan Dam in Mankato to homes and businesses in Cook, Minnesotans are certainly feeling the impact from all of the rain that we've had.
Let me tell you, it is something that you want to make sure you know about, sump pumps, and the rain has to go somewhere, and it could get in your basement. And so we are excited to have our guest with us today.
We are. We asked Andy Berreth from Innovative Basement Authority to explain how sump pumps work and some other signs of water and that it may be entering your home. Andy, it's great to have you with us.
Yeah, great to be here.
I know you guys are super busy right now.
Yes, we are very, very busy.
Tell me about sump pumps, because I actually had a couple of questions about them. One home I owned had a sump pump. The current home that I have now doesn't have a sump pump. Tell me about sump pumps, how they work, and who needs them.
Typically, a sump pump is going to be installed in the lowest portion of your basement, and usually it's in a corner. Should be attached to a drainage system where water is directed to the pump so it can pump it out of the house. Now, some homes have them because of their age. Some homes don't. So there's a code behind that. So depending on when your house was built, would be determined as to whether or not you'd have one or should have one now.
Now, when I sell a home and it doesn't have a sump pump, it's an older home, are you required to put a sump pump in for the new buyers, or is that something that's just kind of grandfathered in?
So it's kind of grandfathered in. One of the things you'd want to make sure you understand is, like, if there's any signs of water intrusion, that needs to be disclosed, right? So that the new homeowner should have that information. It's always good to do that, though. It's always a good step if you're looking to sell your home to go ahead and install a pump and get that problem taken care of ahead of time.
Well, and let's be honest, buying a sump pump's a lot better than doing the damage rework and rebuild of the 100%. Basement.
So what are you guys seeing right now? Where are you working? What are you seeing?
All over. Yeah. We're seeing a lot, you know, not only from the rain that we've received that's continued to cause issues for homeowners, but rising levels in lakes and in the rivers and things like that that's getting into lake homes as well. Something to definitely pay attention to if you're close to the water.
So what do you do about that? I mean, if you start to see water coming in, I mean, we talk a lot about, you know, communities are gathering people to fill sandbags and place them around homes. I mean, is that kind of your first step? Or if you see water coming in, what do you do?
So my encouragement is to call an expert right away. See how fast we can get out to see you to be able to identify exactly what's happening and why.
Yeah.
And so that we can put a good solution to it to help you as fast as we possibly can.
You know, the great thing, too, about technology these days, a lot of sump pumps have alarms or they have things that can go off on your phone.
Yep.
But if people don't have that and maybe we're gone on vacation for a while, are there signs people can look for that there was water intrusion, even if it's not complete flooding?
Yes, there are multiple signs. Some are more clear than others. So obviously, you have water intrusion in your home and anywhere. So if it's coming down the walls, if you can feel the walls are damp or there's actual water on the floor itself. Also, there's something called efflorescence, and it's something that we educate our homeowners on. It's basically a mineral deposit that comes through the concrete wall, whether it's block or poured concrete. It leaves behind a mineral deposit. It's kind of a white, chalky type substance that can flake off of your wall, but that will tell you that water has already been there. So that's something you want to get looked at.
I feel like if you're buying a home or you have a home and you have water in your basement, you feel like, oh my gosh, I'm never going to be able to sell this home. Mm-hmm. It's going to be a complete turnoff. But there are things you can do.
Yes.
Once you figure out how the water is coming in to remedy the problem, and your house will be dry.
Yeah. 100%.
Talk about some of those things people can do.
Yeah. So first thing, you know, is get a dehumidifier. That can help you out a ton, right? And you want to check the humidity levels in your basement. Have a technician come out and service your system if you already have one installed. A technician can come out and diagnose what year the pump is, how long it's been running, you know, what kind of age you may have left in that system so it doesn't catch you off guard, right? So you go to the lake, come home, and you got the issue, right?
I'm glad you mentioned that, because there's times where when I owned a home in Mankato, you know, we lived in the River Valley, I would hear that pump go off all the time. It would constantly be running. Is that a good thing or a bad thing?
I would say it's a good thing. Obviously, if the pump is running, it's working, right? Mm-hmm. The one thing I would pay attention to is if it stops and takes a break. So if it doesn't take a break and then fill up and then pump out again and continuously run that way, if it's always running, that means either one, it's stuck and the motors just keep spinning, or you have so much water coming in that you should have somebody come out and take a look to see if you need a battery backup system or anything to help you with that as well.
You mentioned the pump and taking a look at it and seeing the age of it. They age out. They have like kind of a lifespan.
Yeah, they do. It varies. There's varying warranties with different pumps that you can purchase. Typically, we see anywhere from 5 to 10 years is a good lifespan on a sump pump.
You know, we all kind of don't want it to happen, obviously, flooding in the basement, water. But if it does, when do people call for service? When do they say, okay, this is the time to do it, I can't do it myself anymore?
Yeah, usually it's when they see the problem is already there,
Yeah.
unfortunately. And at that time, you know, coming out and being able to diagnose that, it's never any, you know, it's always cheaper. The sooner you can get it taken care of is always going to be the cheapest for you, because the longer it happens, more issues and more problems can occur, like basement damage, and then that cost is, you know, can go through the roof.
Well, and I was going to ask about that, not to put you on the spot, but I mean, this, it can be costly, right?
Yep.
Hello.
Hello.
Siri, just talk to me. She wants in on the conversation too, yeah. But it can be very, very costly. So, I mean, to have your sump pump inspected early on so that you know that it's working in the event of the rainfall can just be something that is a smart thing to do versus, I mean, $50,000, $60,000, $70,000, right? When people's basements get flooded, if
yeah,
not more.
It could be.
Yeah. When you're talking the rebuilding and the walls and the carpeting and all of that.
Get ahead of it as soon as you can.
Okay.
Thank you for joining us. I mean, it's a conversation that you don't think needs to happen sometimes, especially if you live on a hill or a high place where the rivers may be in the valley.
Right.
And it's something that everyone in Minnesota and Wisconsin should especially know.
I would agree.
Yep. Andy, thank you for coming in.
Thanks
we
for having
me. We know you're
busy.
We appreciate your time.
Appreciate it.
For more information on sump pumps and basement waterproofing, we will post a link to Innovative Basement Authority right on our site at minnesotalive.com.